the foreign aid space, the other side of which a funding equation for the Burnett, is not such a positive story. Both sides of politics have let us down, in my opinion, in the last few years in foreign aid, and not just in the cuts, but more importantly, in fact, in the rhetoric that surrounded those cuts. Foreign aid, of course, can always be delivered better, but it's important that at least everybody here and everybody who hears the message recognises that aid works, and Australian aid works. You know, this year I visited Bangladesh, for example, and Bangladesh's population, that I'm sure many of you in this room would say is out of control and symptomatic of where the world's headed. Bangladesh's population is stagnating and it's about to go down. And the reason it's about to go down has a lot to do with Australian aid. And not only is it about to go down, the economy of Bangladesh is going gangbusters. And the next decade or two promises huge things for that country. What they did, Australian aid, together with Canadian and Sweden and US, is support research activities around very basic things. One of the things the recent Lancet series on Bangladesh demonstrated is that that aid supported the development of an oral rehydration solution for diarrheal diseases. And that Lancet series said that saved that one intervention, aid money that went to make the intervention and then aid money to deliver it, Australian aid money to deliver it to an organisation called BRAC, saved 50 million lives. Just that one intervention. And what followed from that was confidence that mothers had that their children were going to survive. The fertility rate over that period, together with Australian-funded family planning services, has dropped from over 6 to 2.3, which is about replacement. It's just marginally above replacement level. Any lower, which it's still headed, and as I say, after a generation, the population drops. Aid works, and the argument about whether it can be done better is a no-brainer. Of course it can be. Everything can be. But to dismiss it out of hand, as has happened in the last few years, has been very unhelpful and has tilled the soil for the significant cuts we currently see. So that's a more difficult message for us. On the positive side, I think, of aid is the recognition that research is important. This is actually quite a transformational shift for the aid world. And of course, given that we're a research in aid organisation, it's not all doom and gloom for us directly as an organisation. And it's been an important part of my advocacy in the next few years with the federal government, will be focused very hard on that issue, creating mechanisms to support research in aid, which does improve, which helps laser target, just as that oral rehydration solution in Bangladesh laser target interventions to just what you most need the most.